Whisper and Thunder, the whisper of Native American stories, the thunder of stories that demand to be told. Journey of the Message by Pat Estes, featuring her painting by the same title. Rich green grass stands proudly alongside the painted skies of Mother Earth, and alongside them, we too are there, outside. Feet firmly planted, eyes gazing up, we wonder and imagine many great things, limitless possibilities of truth woven within the delicate blankets of the universe. Millions upon millions of eloquent stars wink down at us from above, gently hovering and observing. They are peaceful beings, our greatest audience. So why is it then we mimic their curiosity and enthusiasm, yet feel as though we are somehow separate? Separate from the universe, separate from Creator, separate from animals, and so forth. Can this be true? Or have we simply forgotten their language? Imagine for a bit that we do, in fact, remember how to speak with the stars. Let us close our eyes and envision a bright, effervescent, and timeless star gleaming powerfully in the night sky. This star begins to grow in luminosity, as if maturing, building and collecting information, ancient wisdom, and teachings. Our star dreams of one day sharing this knowledge and insight with all living here on Earth. Suddenly, it begins to morph and shimmer with a vibrant array of saturated colors and quick flashes of white light. It is at this point some would venture to say they believe the star is dying. But is it really? Perhaps our star is revving up to merely twinkle and disco with excitement, vibrating and radiating, consumed with anticipation. Star can clearly see the pivotal time to leap is closing in fast. This is the exact moment all stars look forward to, the opportunity to transcend the comforts of the universe and land ever so softly upon the bosom of our Mother Earth. It leaps with monumental courage, produces an exuberant flash, and gracefully dives into her beating heart. This newly planted starseed can now whisper remarkable truths, visions, and sacred knowledge unto Mother's ears. The information becomes a part of her breath as she exhales out across the lands, through golden fields, soaring hand in hand with sister wind, and flying freely amidst the countless pollens of mystery. The answers of origins are now out in the open for all to hear. Many miles pass quickly until finally Sister Wind slows her pace and blows a delicate kiss. Swirling and twirling, the warm wind and loving kiss make their way to an open kitchen window. Here, they discover beads of sweat forming on the brow of Patricia as she diligently washes dishes. Ah, Patricia feels the warm breeze caressing her brow, almost as if she had been kissed. Patricia enjoys the brief moment, then resumes her dishwashing. She does not complain while doing this chore because it allows her mind a chance to wander, an opportunity to peel her thoughts away from day-to-day stresses and responsibilities. The dishwater comforts and cleanses her inner spirit. She envisions all negative energy, memories, arguments, and worries transcending down her arms, down into the soapy warm water. Not only can this cleaning concoction renew her plates, glasses, flatware, and bowls, but it successfully cleanses our spirits as well. Patricia methodically enters a meditative state. She imagines each item she scrubs to be a representation of her fellow brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers, all spirits from all realms. She clears the hearts, minds, bodies, and illness of others. She repeats this process over and over again, with each new item picked up, rinsed off, and stacked neatly until the lot is finished. Today is a little curious, though. Waves of emotions bounce up and down within Patricia's heart as she carries out her impromptu healing technique. On one hand, her spirit is overflowing with great joy as she knows she is being of assistance to others in some small way. Tip the scales, and a giant thorn of pain and unhappiness tears through her side. It continues to dig deeper and deeper within her flesh. She closes her eyes, tilts her head back, and tries to block out the angry thorn. So many things happening all at once. The warmth, the breeze, dishes clanking about in the sink, bubbles, water rushing, scrubbing, heart weeping. Defeated warrior tears emerge with great vengeance from her eyes. Why so much pain? Where is this coming from? Have I missed something? Someone? These questions continue to roll in her mind. Finally, reaching a breaking point, she simply lets go, as if choosing to swan dive from atop the Grand Canyon itself. Inhaling and exhaling, connecting with her heart, Patricia finds herself traveling down a dimly lit hallway. In her mind's eye, the passage is remarkably quiet, dark, and very lonely. It looks as though no one has been down this direction in years, possibly many years. Inhale. Faint shimmer from a golden doorknob screams out from the darkness, directing Patricia towards a chamber, a dwelling long forgotten within the confines of her heart. Exhale. Closing in, she wraps her inquisitive fingers around the knob and leans against the heavy door. It slowly creaks open. The years of closure have caused this door to become rusted, stiff, and almost fused entirely shut. Inside, Patricia discovers a small room. It has the standard four walls, and crouched within one of the farthest corners sits a fear-filled child, a young girl huddled and shaking, starving, filthy, weak with head down upon her knees. Could this be? Patricia questions herself. Yes, it is. This innocent, shivering, lonely little girl is in fact Patricia's own great spirit, laying here weeping, utterly alone and forgotten. Child, please stop crying. How did you get locked in here? How did this happen? Patricia asks. Great Spirit Child takes a moment to gather herself. With her tiny forearm, she wipes seemingly endless tears from her soaking face. Lifting her head, she gazes deep into Patricia's eyes and tells her, "You left me here. You forgot about me. Do you not remember? Do you not even recognize me anymore? I have missed you so much. I love you. Thank you for finding me." Everything stops. Any attempt at movement or response is impossible. Patricia immediately feels as if she's been turned to solid granite. Even the essence of all time and space, every inch of the universe becomes dark and quiet, immobilized. Time desperately struggles to hang on in the midst of such paralyzing stillness. Eventually, things start to sink in and absorb. Spirit Child's words resemble long-awaited raindrops being released from the heavens. Downward they travel until landing gracefully upon the thirstiest of soils. The dam separating Patricia's heart and mind explodes and quickly becomes knocked down. Resilient floodwaters begin rushing majestically once more. Patricia's realization of her own unhappiness suddenly surfaces from the rushing waters like a long-lost ancient city of Atlantis, a city which has been buried deep within the earthly mountains for endless moons. It rears itself up from the belly of our mother and glistens brightly in the rays of Father's sun. Great Spirit Child stands steadfast and strong on the highest peak of the tallest building amidst the surfacing city. She is screaming now, not in anger or rage, but screaming, so that she can be heard above the sounds of reconnection whipping through Patricia's mind. Hear me now, now and forever. Always remember me and always listen to your heart. I am here eternally. I am you. I am your gift of creativity. A sudden explosion of emotions has Patricia's hands digging deep within the chalice of sacred dishwater now. Eyes clenched, tears falling like picturesque rainfalls from the Amazons. Blood pumping wildly. Ka! 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 Exhale. Her eyes burst open, allowing immense sunlight to rush in. Ka! Patricia regains her focus. Ka! Ka! She is utterly bewildered to see the most beautiful black crow perched in an adolescent palm tree just outside her kitchen window, flapping his wings enthusiastically demanding attention. Spirit crow glistens like mysterious obsidian in the afternoon sunlight. Ka! Her awakened brown eyes and his rich dark opals lock together. Their souls embrace as they transition into a familiar dance. Music is not necessary, for the kin spirits immediately recognize each other from many times past. Times which witness the sun being born. Ages which remember Mother Earth's first breath. This very moment is amazing indeed. A few days pass, and Patricia finds herself starting another work week. Her shift at the local tavern starts with the usual routine. She does not mind too much. After all, most jobs consist of routine. The expectation of anything beyond the ordinary is rather unexpected. Buffing the bar top, polishing the glassware, cutting and preparing fruit for the assorted liquid spirits, Patricia is more than aware of her indirect assistance with killing people softly through overindulgence. It is not her romanticized idea of changing the world for the better. After all, she did have big dreams of amazing ways to help people on a global scale. But they never really panned out, regardless. Her job as a barmaid provides her with the typical means of survival in today's society. A roof over her head, food in the cupboards, and electricity at the touch of her fingertips. Hello! Patricia spins around like a startled red fox. White Wolf! Hi! Well, what a surprise, she exclaims. I had no idea you'd be by today. So great to see you. Many hugs all around. Patricia truly enjoys being in the presence of her friend White Wolf. He is not usually seen too often. White Wolf stays busy carrying out his daily work, yet still manages to inspire and teach many things to a great deal of people. Even Patricia will confess, happily, that she too has learned much from White Wolf. The two quickly dive into catching up on things, family, friends, and day-to-day activities. Then, as always, they save the juicy parts for last. Their conversing leads to more spiritually sound affirmations and journeys. Dream states of enlightenment and teachings, if you will. Patricia is eager to share with White Wolf her profound experience from a few days prior. Heart racing, she tells White Wolf of how her mind had not been in a good place, how her heart had felt empty and broken, a feeling as though an enormous fog had blocked her sense of sight and judgment. The tale continues to unfold. Being in the kitchen, the dishes, being startled by an unexpected visit from a mystical crow. She even mentions discovering her spirit child locked away and forgotten deep within her heart. Eventually, as Patricia's story came to an end, she confessed to White Wolf that she is sure Crow was telling her something on a much deeper level. However, she is simply unclear as to what it is exactly. A rather long pause filled with comforting smiles carried on for a bit between Wolf, now that the formalities are out of the way, and Patricia, chuckling slightly. Wolf tells her, "You received a message. A message delivered to you by Spirit Crow." The Lakota people tell powerful stories and hold many strong beliefs as to how Creator communicates with us through messages. messages that are passed unto Spirit Eagle, Spirit Hawk, and Spirit Crow. These three carry all sacred messages from Creator and deliver them to us here, walking on the flesh of Mother Earth. Wolf smiles. He's always smiling.